the science of Attack on Titan. That's all from me. Thank you.
Oke, ini aku kasih konteks dulu ya teman-teman. Jadi kemarin itu aku habis bikin story di Instagram pas aku lagi bikin slide presentasi untuk ujian di kampus yang isinya adalah bahasan tentang the science of Attack on Titan. Dan gak cuman itu, terus juga aku tunjukin foto, ya foto seadanya sih. Foto pas aku presentasi di depan kelas dan cuplikan video dikit gitu pas pada tepuk tangan dan ngasih komen dikit. Nah terus dari itu malah banyak yang nge-reply dan minta untuk video fullnya posting di YouTube aja dong, kayak gitu. Sebenarnya aku gak niat ini untuk diposting di YouTube gitu ya teman-teman. Karena pertama, sebenarnya secara isi ini tuh udah pernah aku bahas di videoku sebelumnya yang Attack on Titan. Isinya sama persis, bahkan lebih pendek ini. Tapi ya udahlah, karena banyak yang minta, ini nanti akan aku liatin teman-teman. Sekalian juga kalau mungkin pada penasaran gimana respon dari apa profesornya, dari dosennya, dari teman-temanku juga yang nonton gitu. Jadi ini tuh adalah ujian presentasi untuk kuliah Science Communication. Ya intinya adalah pelajaran tentang gimana caranya untuk menyampaikan sains ke publik. Ya intinya kayak yang biasanya aku lakukan di YouTube gitu loh. Dan ini ujian presentasi, waktunya maksimal 3 menit dan topiknya itu bebas. Dan di sini aku milih topik The Science of Attack on Titan. Udah sih gitu aja, jadi ya silahkan ditonton aja teman-teman. Cuman disclaimer ya, bahasa Inggrisku belepotan, oke.
Okay, I will start with a quick question. So, who has ever heard about the anime Attack on Titan? You can raise your hand. Okay, 1,000 people. Okay, amazing. So, in short, Attack on Titan is an anime about a group of people that fight against a giant called Titan. And then, the question is, scientifically speaking, is it possible for Titan to exist in real life? So, if we see here, the smallest one is human and all the other are Titan, with the biggest one is 60 meter high. So, in fact, if we see to the real world, the biggest creature on Earth nowadays is African bush elephant with a height of just 3 meters. And no other living thing is bigger than this elephant. And of course, no one is as big as Titan. Yeah. but why? Why no one is bigger? So, one of the primary reason is because of the problem of scaling. So, take for example, we have a cube with a side of 1 meter, so that the volume and the area, side area, has the same value. And then, if we increase the size of the cube to 10 meters, we can see here that the volume increased significantly compared to the area. And this is the point. So, on a living thing, volume is related to weight, and the area is related to the strength of muscle of the bone. So, even though Titan exists in real life, their bones and their muscle are not strong enough to lift their weight, so they will just collapse. That's why Titan doesn't exist in real world. Then, does it mean Attack on Titan is wrong? Well, no. So, Hajime Sensei is a clever writer, so he overcome this problem by stating the fact that Titan, although they are that big, they still have a small mass. So, yes, theoretically, Titan is still possible in real world, at least in the world of Attack on Titan. And, of course, there are still many questions about this, and there are a book that dedicated to discuss all about this, the science of Attack on Titan. That's all from me, thank you.
Two minutes, 30 seconds. should talk about dinosaurs. I think I remember you didn't talk about scales.
Oh,
no, really nice. And you know, good introduction and question to everybody at the beginning. Nice cultural references. Lots of good animation. Sort of clips and graphics and things from the novel. So really nice.
And it doesn't matter if people haven't seen Attack on the Titan. Attack on Titan, because we've all seen giants in literature and so on. So the idea you had that scaling of it's this really big thing. I mean, it doesn't matter if you've not seen the film. Sounds good.
I think the structure was really good because you can so easily sort of, we always want to put even more information in, but you just kept it simple and you just looked at the sort of the size and the strength and you just broke it down by slide even into those steps, which just made it really digestible and really easy to sort of take on. You could see the scale up of the volume. That's what you have, a slide for each of that, and that actually really helped visualize it for the audience. So I think the structure was really well thought out there. So yeah, really well done.
Thank you. I liked it when the cube got bigger. That made me chuckle. I don't know why. Yeah, it just proper made me chuckle when it got bigger on the screen. It wasn't like a bigger cube. It was the same cube, but just zoomed in. It was like, so poor. It was amazing. I know. It was just amazing.
Yeah, it was so nice you took the time over that, because that was the crux, that was your one key message, and you made it so simple with breaking it down, like Steph said. So you didn't assume, and you didn't brush over that too quickly, because it was so core to what you were trying to answer. And you could have very easily assumed that was obvious, and you just sort of skipped over it, but you didn't. You took the time to kind of cover it really well, nicely designed slides.
There might be a real world, so giants aren't real, but in real life, birds essentially overcome this, right? Because birds have hollow bones to reduce their weight so that their strength can, because if a bird was made of bones like we are, they couldn't fly because they're not strong enough. So there's some, you have time, so you know, if you do this thing, and then adding in, I mean, the cultural reference is really, it's really good. So look, this whole idea of you make them lighter, sure, that's a literary trick, but actually it's not completely implausible to let's make this animal lighter, because birds do that.
Yeah. And I guess you could also mention that on other planets the limitations might be different. I think you seem to remember that from your talk.
Yeah, so like, if humans grew up on Mars, for example, how would they get taller? So how physiology
changes
with gravity.
So maybe Titan came from a different planet.
Titan.
I don't know if you reference, I'm not culturally cold, am I?
Just four dinosaurs, please.
Thank you.
Thank you.